All right, we're filming. Pat's going to catch Mr. T. You notice they're standing there all calm. Pat's coming in the gate with a halter. I want you to watch Mr. T's response when he sees that halter. Pat thinks he's Mr. Master and he's going to be easy to catch him. You see Mr. T? He's already kind of picked up that halter. If you try to hide it, he'll know you got it. So there's Pat walking up with a halter. If he catches Mr. T, I'll be impressed. Mr. T's already gaining ground. So Pat's going to have to get in front of that drive line. He went in too fast. I think he kind of blew it there. So now he pushed Mr. T farther. Now he's got to get in front of that drive line. He got him stopped. Back away. Anytime he looks at you, back away. You want him to think that if I look at him, I can make him stop chasing me. Mr. T's kind of been kind of a pain in the butt too. I haven't caught him a lot, and I've been doctoring his feet. So he knows when he gets caught, I'm going to come messing with his feet. You want to try to probably stay in front of that drive line? Yeah. Oh man, he's got you now. Cut him off. You almost got him. Cut him. Go into him. Go into him. Push him. There you go. There you go. So buddy's kind of semi-paying attention here. Hopefully you can see. I'm trying, having a hard time seeing. He's not giving a whole lot of release. Good. Give that pause and release. Try to anticipate which way he's going to go so you're thinking I've got to move before, as soon as he starts to make that move on how he's going to get away. So he's only got two ways to go, so you got to kind of be ready to go in that direction. There you go. That's all right. Good. Stopped his movement. Good. Stopped his movement. Good. Watch out. You kind of look like you're running on him. You're moving. Move fast to stop him, then you got to stop running. So he's coming back to buddy, which is good. Now, yeah, then you got to slow down and relax. You can't stay in that that chase mode, or Mr. T's gonna, I was directing him and wasn't directing him on the camera here. Got your hands behind your back, it's gonna make him more nervous. He knows you're sneaking, but that's all right, you got close enough. Don't pat, just rub. Yeah, you blew it. What happened, Mr. Catcher? I can catch him in 2 minutes, horse whisperer. I know what I'm doing. He's not a hard horse to catch. There you go. See, he started to go in because I was talking and egging him in. He looked at you. If you could back away and get him to take a step, that would go huge for him kind of following you. But that's all right. As long as you can touch him and relax, right now you're letting him relax. I wouldn't do anything else until his head kind of dropped, because then that would tell me he's loosing. But most people get in a hurry. They want to go in there. Now, if you kind of reached underneath his neck and grabbed him right now, you could probably catch him. He may get away, but if you lose it, it's going to be a big fail. If you take the time it takes, it takes less time. Now rub his back while you're rubbing his front. No, no. No, no. Same hand. Ah. Keep that hand in the front as a barrier before you put that hand on the back. There. Don't leave that on his back like that. That slides off. It'll scare him. Rub him with it. And now if you put both hands together around his neck, now you got him. Collect those ropes. Good boy. Stand. Man, you're lucky he's a good horse, because you screwed that shit up. Don't put that halter on. Just put it around his neck. Loop it. Hold that halter and hold that rope just so you can lead him. He ain't gonna pull away from you. Nice and long. Give him plenty of room. Hold two ends. Both. There you go. And now he'll follow you. There. Now by moving him this way without going for his head, right now you're showing dominance. He's showing submissiveness. You've caught him. Too many people want to try and put that halter on right away in the middle of the field, and that's just too much pressure for a horse. He moved him, he got his head. The horse is thinking right now, well, hell, he's already got me. So now if he goes to his head and tries to put that halter on, it's not going to be as traumatic as when he first catches him, and he's still got, I got to get away, oh no, he's going for my face, now he's getting by my eyes, now he's getting by my ears, and you never give him that release. Those few steps, remember a horse, when they move their feet, they relax, they breathe, they don't feel trapped. And when you lower a horse's stress, you're going to make the next thing you do to him easier. So by walking him a little bit, he's dropping his head. He's kind of figuring out he's caught. Now he can put the halter on a whole lot easier. You want to put the halter on? You can. You still got him. You keep that loop around him. You haven't done it in a while, so I don't even know if you remember or you do it wrong. I'll just laugh at you if you do it wrong. That's all right. Remember, the double loop with the two knots goes over his nose, and the loop to tie goes on your side, and the long end goes on this side. Goes around his neck. There you go. You almost got it right, I think, right there. There you go. I think that's right. Ah, you got it in his lip, dude. Don't be freaking hurting my horse. Take that shit off. Take that off. When you put that on there, don't hang on to the back of the halter. Hang on to the bottom of the halter. So you got to clear it there. You don't want to peel his lip back. You peeled his lip back with that rope. That's going to make him not want to be haltered. That's going to make him halter shy. That's why people, my horse won't let me halter, because you probably halter him like a damn idiot. Now, you good. See, he reached over instead of throwing it. Most people want to throw it. Buddy, don't come over and get his camera. I'll beat you like a stepchild. I know. I see you. Get your big old head out of the way. But I'm going to beat you like a... I know. You're a good boy. All right. So he's going to tie that little loose knot there. Again, he's got that loop around him, so if he gets in a jam, he can kind of relax. He's still got him. He's not going to be able to run off, even though he's dropped his side, so he's not really paying attention. If Mr. T wanted to, he'd get away. Now slide that off his neck. There you go. Slide that around. So you don't need that loop around his neck now. You got his head. Okay, yeah, you can do it that way, or you can just pull it. Now stop moving like you're trying to catch him and just move normal like he's going to get comfortable that, hey, this isn't scary. I'm caught. And then walk him over here to the camera. Don't ball up that rope like that. You'll get caught in your fingers. Should be hanging, so if he runs off, it can just unwind easy. There you go. Don't wrap it. Good. All right, that's good. All right, Mr. T, you're a good old boy. Not too bad. Could have been better. Patrick, you need some serious training, dude.